Hello, 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 hello. Listen, in my feet of trying to get everything done, here I go, leaving the overlay on the screen. Hello, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to a special presentation, because you all know that Miss B do not go live this early in the day, okay? However, this is a special, you know, when I come out and put on my good jewelry and my good clothes, you know, it's for a reason, okay? So we have a special guest today, and it's going to be amazing. You all listen, gather, share, bring all of your people, especially those who have been, you know, who have been dealing with ailments in their bodies, who have been dealing with lack of mobility, you know, pain in their bones, in their muscle, in their skeletal system, all of those things, bring them in. That means your mother, your father, your grandparents. That means your daughters, your sons, everybody, bring them in, because this is for everybody, okay? You all hear me talking about all the time about your multiple beings inside of yourself. So we do, you know, I do healing in all areas when it comes down to your multiple inner beings, right? Your ethereal self, your emotional self, your mental self, your sexual self, all of those things. But we cannot forego our physical self. Hello. All right. And so we have a guest today that is going to be bringing all of the knowledge, all of the things. You all, I'm so excited to get you all in front of this man and this man in front of you. Okay. So if you, like I said, if you're here, go ahead and share. Thank you for being here. First off, we appreciate you. We appreciate your support in advance. Okay. And I'm telling you now, you're going to be so elated. You're going to be so informed. You're going to be so excited, and you're going to walk away being able to do what? Heal yourself. Come on, somebody. Listen, turn to your neighbor to the right or the left and say, heal myself. Okay. So the goal is to get us out of the medicinal pharmaceutical arena. Okay, that's the goal, because the answers are within, and the answers are on this planet Earth and not in somebody's science lab and chemical, you know, lab and all of those things, man-made stuff that would suppress one area, but then cause 19,000 side effects in other areas. You understand what I'm saying? When we are healed, we are healed. There should be no other side effects outside of healing. Hello, that's it. That's all. And so that's what we are talking about here today, your physical healing. Okay. I am excited because he's helped me. Listen, y'all don't even understand. He has helped me because I dealt with a sciatic in my back, and my goodness, y'all, that thing will take you out of here. Okay. That thing will paralyze you. Well, you could be in the middle of doing something and it will just seize you up right there. My goodness, the shooting pains. If you all have dealt with that, I'm telling you now, get here, park yourself, get your questions together, because we will be taking them. If ever you want to get on the screen, you let me know and I will shoot you the link so that you can get on the screen and ask the master healer a question directly himself. Okay, today is the day. Get your answers, get your questions together, get your answers for your questions. All right, now, who are you talking about, Miss B? I am talking about the one, the only, the man, the myth, the legend. Okay, Uriel N. Riley. He is the founder of You Are Healing. Okay, the founder of You Are Healing. There's a program that he specialized and put together to allow you to breathe into your healing, your breath, your air, to breathe into your own healing, your own stretches, your own modality, your own mobilities and things like that. He created a phenomenal modality, a phenomenal program for us to be able to breathe into our own healing, okay? With assisted stretching, with pressure point, you know, focus on pressure points in the areas of your feet and in your hands, all of those things. Listen, y'all. Listen, okay? No thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars in treatments and surgeries and all of those things. He himself dealt with sciatic issues and bone issues and muscle issues coming from an athletic background. He himself dealt with all of those things, torn ACLs and all of those things. You understand what I'm saying? And he stretched his way out. Look at your neighbor and say, stretched his way out. Do you hear me? So that's what we're going to be doing today. We're talking about the master healer, the father, the author, the poet. Okay. Oh my God. Listen, The list goes on and on and on and on and on. I'm telling you, man, myth, legend. I'm telling you, y'all. Okay. Hello, 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 Malachi. Thank you for coming in and tuning in. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Okay. So now you are healing founder. And listen, let me tell y'all something. And this is just for me. I don't know if I'm alone here, but if you can take a gander at what's on the screen, brother is not, he's not bad on the eyes. You understand me? A gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous individual. You hear me? I'm just saying. I had to say it. I had to say it because, I mean, hello, it's obvious. You know, however, this man is amazing. The spirit of this man, man, you're talking about beauty on the face. His spirit transcends all of that. Okay. You think he's gorgeous in physique? No, he's gorgeous in spirit. And his smile will light up a freaking room. His smile is the sun. Okay. I tell him all the time, you emit the sun. It's contagious. It's infectious. I'm telling you now, this is who you want. If you have a healer, if you're connected to anyone that says that they are a healer, this is one that you want, because he is not just mouthpiece. He is absolutely through and through who he says he is. And because of that, I had to bring him here for you all, okay? All righty, so I'm just going to give you a brief intro, and then after his intro, you'll see his face again. Master healer, international athletic trainer. I'm telling you, Uriel N. Riley. Here we go.
Yes. 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 You can never, ever give up. We are all one.
Yes. All right. All right. All right. All right. Uriel Riley, how are you, sir?
Peace. Gratitude, Queen. Oh, man. What a beautiful day.
A beautiful, beautiful day. And it's even more beautiful because you are here with us right here at Miss B's platform. I mean, come on. Did you ever think?
I am so honored, Miss B.
Yes.
Dr. Miss B, let's be correct.
Come on, listen, you better tell them from the rooftop, okay? She got that doctorate. Yes, she did. And I'm so excited about that. But, you know, it was really just to satisfy the people who require the doctorate for me to do the things that I do. You know what I mean? But it is what it is. I was the doctor before they told me I was. Hello, somebody. Okay. So there it is. All righty. We have someone on YouTube that said the Butterfly Whisperer. Come on, Butterfly Whisperer. They said Uriel is a real gift to the world. Okay, the Butterfly Whisperer approves. Registered trademark Butterfly Whisperer approved. Hello, somebody. Thank you so very much for tuning in. Yes, you all. Yes, 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 yes. Go ahead and share, you all. Share, share, share. This has to go across everybody's platform. I'm telling you now, because the information that he's about to share with us, you do not want to miss. You don't want to miss. Okay. You want to be able to share to others. Even if you yourself are not dealing with some of the matters, you want to spread the word. You want to spread the information. You want to spread the knowledge so that everyone can be healed and can heal themselves with the information. Even in the Bible, it talks about the people perish for the lack of knowledge. Okay. Knowledge. Okay. So Uriel is going to give us some knowledge. So please, please, please introduce yourself from your own words. You know what I mean? I know I didn't do any justice, but introduce yourself.
Wonderful. And I just want to honor you and say congratulations for this beautiful platform as well, and as well as all your work. I'm a master fitness trainer and a father to a 16-year-old daughter. So I love being a father and hand-delivered my daughter. And I think that's what really set me on the path of awareness, you know, what I wanted more for my future. And so that's what I devised Your Healing for. Your Healing was about making athletes and people better than they are, you know, and it starts with the flexibility. Yeah. When you're dealing with working out, there are three segments that you have to deal with, and that's your flexibility, the strength, and then your endurance of your muscles. Right. And so when you combine all of that, you understand oxygen is the main component in those. Mm-hmm. So then you combine that with diaphragmatic breathing, and you understand that's the most cleanest air that we breathe from our diaphragm. So if we concentrate on breathing that air to our parts of our body, we'll not only extend more, but we also clear out blockages within the circulatory system, because we have an electrical source, which is our heart, right? Mm-hmm. And so it all comes together, and everything, that's what we learn in with polarities, vibrational therapy, is in meridian therapy, is everything affects everything.
It does.
So what you eat, it's what you listen to, it's how loud you listen to things, it's what you're watching, which goes into your eyes, and that goes into the occipital lobe of the brain. So, you know, and that's all based on the CNS. So it's all encompassing. What I was looking for was something that would make athletes better. And then I started to use it against different motor neuron diseases, as well as all types of cancers and so on and so forth. And it would take literal tumors. They would go back to their oncologist, and their tumors would be gone, firstly, in their diaphragm, if they had them, or along the spine. So it's very, very important, that diaphragmatic breath alone. But breathing to the muscles, it opens up a concentration in the mind as well. So then that's when you have to learn how to focus your thoughts. And so having someone to help you assist in those stretches, as opposed to stretching them yourself and breathing to them, allows you to relax and just breathe and concentrate on that mind.
Right. That, okay. Okay. So everybody just chew on that. What was just given to us. Listen, everything you just said, like, we can pass the collection plate right now. Okay. Because, whoa, that is so serious. Everything affects everything. We are so, I talked about this the other day. We are so magnificently crafted. I'm talking about our beings, because we are the mirroring image of infinite intelligence, of all things, one source. Listen. If there's a huge system, if there's a system in how the universe operates, then we're all synergetically connected to that system. We have individual systems, yes, but all of our individual systems collectively working together makes for a magnificent flow. So that's why it's important for us to connect with all of the things, cosmically, earthly, nature-wise, all types of things. And you said something that was so key, and I don't think people really realize this. I know this is just my downtime, and I just want to catch a show or two, or, I mean, that's my artist. I love that song, or that beat, that bass, that 808. I just got to hear that. Listen, what you consume in all facets, and I'm not just talking about fork to mouth, what you consume via your eye gates, your ear gates, your mouth gates, even sexually, hello, because that is a gate. Okay, what you consume attaches itself to you, and then you become what you consume.
That's right.
You understand what I'm saying? So that's why these things, this information is necessary for your physical self, your mental self, your emotional self, your spiritual self, your sexual self, your ethereal, all of those selves on the inside of you. They have to keep the connection so that you can keep the flow, so that you can get the best out of not just this physical life, your spiritual life, your mental life, you know what I'm saying? Your intellectual life, your sexual life, all of those lives that are within there. And it's up to you as the governor make sure that all of those entities are flowing properly so that you can flow properly.
That's right. You that's right. That
breath. And that, goodness.
And it's, and just so you put that so perfectly, because our cycles in our body have a actual time that they're more heightened. when we're dealing with the meridians, right? Yeah. So like the triple warmer is from 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. They go in 2-hour cycles. From there is the gallbladder, right? From 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. Then the liver from 1 a.m. to 3 a.m. And then the lungs. And they all have a polarity as well, a yin and a yang. So once we have the awareness, oh, this normally happens around this time. Right. Then we can analyze, if we have the information, we have the awareness, we can say, you know, my stomach really starts to feel some sort of way when I wake up around 7 a.m. And then you look and you say, oh, that's a yang polarity. And that's from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. Now we have an awareness. Now we can say, how do we balance it, right? And right. Then we look at the colors that it works for. And it's a yellow. So if we look at things that are yellow, we can help to balance it. If we use a vibrational sound, oh, that's a balance for the stomach. And of course, that O is coming from the solar plexus. So that's why I derived the harmonic vibrational chart as well, so that people can get a great awareness and understanding of where they are. Because reflecting on everyone else doesn't do us any justice for our health. Wow. It actually puts you in a state where you'll compare yourself. And if you're comparing yourself, you're not mastering yourself. So I like to master myself and not compare myself.
Yeah, yeah. Listen, first off, again, bars. Okay, y'all, are y'all picking up what he's putting down? Because listen to me. I'm so glad this thing is recorded, because I'm going to have to play this back myself to gather all of the things and really just really sit with them and just, you know, kind of really breathe them in, honestly. Okay, I don't know if you all heard what he said, because he slid it in there, the colors and the vibrations and the harmonic tunes and all of those things. When he stated earlier, everything affects everything. If we think about it, that's why some like fast food restaurants, that's why they choose the colors that they choose, because they know that it's going to trigger certain areas in you to make you want to go to their restaurant and eat food. Probably even when you are not hungry, they're triggering certain things in you, even down to sound. There's a reason why certain sounds are the way that they are, so that it triggers it affects certain areas in you that is so that you can get a response. Okay. Out of the thing. Even down to television, entertainment, television. It tells you what your thoughts and what your feelings are going to be. Okay. All of those things, it tells you what it is. And then you wasn't even feeling a certain type of way before you started watching this. And then all of a sudden you're feeling some type of way. You know what I'm saying? It's so many things that really affects everything. So we have to really, really, really be mindful of these things and then be knowledgeable and don't just see things. These conversations right here allows you to not just look at things just as, oh, that's just, oh, I that minimizing. Oh, that's just whatever. No, you're actually paying more intentional attention to certain things, to certain exposures, to certain matters, to certain conversations, whether you're a part of it or even overhearing it, because some things that you overhear can drop into your spirit and it can affect you too. We have to really filter those things so that we can be our very best, highest self. I know I'm just me on Facebook, who this was my very best friend when we were in elementary school and grammar school and things like that. But she said self-awareness is definitely key. Learning to be in tune with oneself. Learning to be in tune with oneself. She also said govern ourselves accordingly at the highest level. Okay. And then Samika on Facebook, she says deep, not to compare, yet master self. Because if you are compared, you stated that if you are comparing yourself to another somebody, then that means that you are no longer mastering you. You're too busy over here.
That's right. And that's what learning the principles of healing sound. You know, the eight principles. So when you learn about pitch, right? The most focused energy, whatever it is what vibrates the highest.
Yes.
So so if you are consuming a high protein diet, right?
Yeah.
This is going to affect how your muscle assimilates calciums and mm-hmm. so on and so forth, because whichever saturation, our bodies are so incredibly divinely made that mm-hmm. whichever is more saturated, it's going to, and wherever it's deficient at, it will pull from certain areas to right. compensate. And right. we do that with everything. So even just looking at the actual places we go, what types of people are around, right? What types of sounds are we listening to? Whichever is going to be the highest in consumption,
right,
is going to be where our frame of mind state is going.
Yes.
To be. So that's why music is so
dominant thoughts. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, we
and
do.
Our nervous system responds to all of it. So yeah. That's what learning about the autoimmunity, mm-hmm. autoimmune system. That is literally a response. It's like a masterful God property that we have, where our body responds to anything that is not natural for our body.
Wow.
Some type of reaction happens, whether right. it be internally, whether it be externally. So that's where learning, again, the principles of healing sound with resonance. Right. You have forced resonance, and then you have mm-hmm. sympathetic resonance. Mm-hmm. And so that's what I tried to do with all these modalities. It's just make it easier for our youth, as well as the people that come and encounter it, to be able to understand mastering themselves, as opposed to, you know, spending that focus looking at other people.
Awesome. That is amazing. You all, I want you to see up close and personal about breathing and assisted stretching and breathing into your stretching. I want you to see, there's going to be two examples. One with the, I think the arms is a longer video, but I want you to see a little bit of the arms and a little bit of the legs. Some of these people they were suffering from strokes and all of those things, and you were able to rehabilitate them by way of breathing diaphragmically, breathing into their stretches and healing, getting their mobility back, getting their movement, their, you know, their abilities back without dealing with the, again, pharmaceuticals and all of those things. You were able to Correct. Restore them.
Correct.
Wow.
Correct.
You all check this out. Okay.
You got it, Don. That's it. Inhaling the greatness. We're releasing any doubts, any worries. Perfect. Two more. Great. One more. Yes. Nice.
This time, here we go. This is already a good start where it's at. This is crucial. Breathing right to it. Excellent. That's it. There you go. Two more. That's it. You're basically touching that. One more. And you're touching, no problem.
Wow. Now, see, in some of those areas, first off, let me just say this. I haven't stretched like that in years. Do you hear me? So to be able to have my arm, and I think when I watched the video with you stretching the young man behind, you know, with his arms, I heard, before you lowered his arm, I heard a final pop.
That's right.
I heard it. And so Yeah. And so you can hear the inhale, and then at the release of the exhale, you know, that's when you're able to move your breathing into a deeper stretch, a deeper pull, a deeper elasticity. You know what I'm saying? Where you're gaining those things, and you're pulling and stretching, and you're loosening the stiffness. You're becoming more tender in those areas, so that you do have those movements and stuff like that. Now, also,
and a restoration of the blood flow as well.
Exactly,
it cleans out those blockages. You know,
yeah.
And that's what is so awesome about those videos. And gratitude, mm-hmm. that is perfect, because it shows where they started at, right?
Yeah.
And both of those people that was after multiple sessions, but it shows just in those little clips where they began and how their breath took them deeper, yeah, into the stretch. And yeah, that self-healing, you know, that's why I always repeat to them, you're healing yourself. Keep going, that's, you right, know.
That's right. And it was one of them where, I don't know if it was that video with the arms, where you were saying, okay, breathe in. And when you breathe in, you said, think about all of the heaviness and all of the things, all of the stress, whatever that you're dealing with. And when you release it all out. Release it all out. And so, like you said, assisted stretching is, it, like you said, you remove the work from them and you take it on yourself as the healer. You take it on, and then the only focus that they have is their breath and the release.
That's right. Their breath
is focused. Their focus, and half the time they may not even realize that they are stretching and so flexible right now. You are in the shape of a pretzel and don't even know it, because you're focusing on releasing and breathing. You know what I'm saying? The next thing you know, you're sitting yoga style. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, wait a minute. I have not been in this position since I was a child. Okay. That's amazing. That is awesome.
And you know, and that's why it's important to go all of the body. You know, we have, yeah, those 640 skeletal muscles, yeah, and it's important to stretch all of them so that you don't become lopsided. It's the stay balanced, you know,
right,
and it creates a balance in your body, because your body naturally will assimilate to the positions that are comfortable. So, for instance, I like to give this example of how it works. Right. Mm-hmm. So think of like a hurricane going on outside, and you're inside the house and you have all the windows closed. Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. Now, the hurricane that's going on outside, the whirlwind, is your breath. Right. Mm. So when you start to stretch an area, what you're doing is opening up. And breathe to it is opening up that window. Now, yeah, what's going to happen? All that air is going to rush in through, right, that area. Right. So you're literally directing your diaphragmatic breath at, mm, that part of the body.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's why it has so much great releases as well.
Mm-hmm.
As well as, you know, we're expelling it in that carbon dioxide that we,
true,
we exhale.
Right.
So very, very, very important.
That's good. That's good. Now talk about pressure points. Okay. Talk about the pressure points. And I want to show a video of you working on pressure points in the feet. I know that we do not pay enough attention to pressure points. We don't realize, especially in the feet and the hands specifically, but I learned that in the feet, the feet triggers so many areas in our bodies, our teeth, our eyes, our hands, our arms, our everything points on the feet, points in the hand. So I want to show this. So it's showing you working on someone's pressure points. Okay. And really, really relieving whatever tension or whatever, you know, stagnation. Okay. That will be in their bodies. Okay. Take a look, you all.
This is where you're going to begin, on the big toe and the next toe right there. You're going to go down the line, pushing the buttons here. Okay. Pushing the buttons and rub,
pushed buttons. Rub two hands at a time. So you're just letting it rest and you're doing the push the buttons. Make sure you get that heel button and the sides. Those are very key because this is zone 5 where the ACL is. So you want to make sure that you're getting all these buttons here. Take your time. You'll feel those little pops like we did before and go at zone 5. Now you want to combo zone 5 with zone 1, okay? So combo zone 5 up and down it with the zone 1 big toe. This is very
wow. And in those areas there, so, and I like how you're saying push the buttons, push, because they are literal buttons.
Yes.
Let's talk more about the pressure point and the importance of operating on those pressure point areas.
Okay. Yeah. So here.
It's okay. It's okay.
The LA for you, right? Hollywood. So in our feet and hands, that's why they look different than every part of our body.
Right.
Because these are nerve endings. Yeah. So we can contact every single part of our body by pressuring, hitting those pressure points in hands and feet. And that's why I wanted to go couple that with the assisted stretching to give an overall and internal healing.
Right.
The pressure points, you can contact the internal organs and help them breathe. So like, for instance, one place that we always breathe to on the feet is the lymph drainage. So it would be in the cusp of the foot is where your lymph drainage, and we press in there and breathe to it. And now that's going to start releasing all that gook that is in that lymph. Yes, that's what's important, is to move that gook out of it. So it makes people pull the bathroom more regular. And get those toxins out that have been stored, because our body has a way of distributing everything that we put into our body.
Right.
And so the lymph drainage is where the actual gook, yuckiness, the mucus areas where they go, and we can contact them. So, and with the pressure points of the skeletal muscles, there's 322 that contact the skeletal muscles. Mm-hmm. So within that, we can press into the forearm and breathe to it. What it's going to do is release that tension, because that's, again, dealing with the electrical system of the body.
Right.
And so once we start to move that and stimulate that electrical system, it's basically like if you would think of a switchboard, right? That as you have on the side of your house, right? Mm-hmm. And what happens with people that have motor neuron diseases that are with, or like strokes, is basically something in the switchboard has been shut off. And so that's what the pressure points does. It helps to get to those electrical spots that have been turned off and turn them back on.
Mm-hmm.
And the overall healing of the internal external mechanisms of the body. So like the neck, the throat, the parathyroid, the trachea, all these are contacted. You can contact in through the feet.
My goodness. I told y'all, I don't think we really give our structural selves the credit, or even the creator, for structuring, for forming and creating and being so intricate with the areas. I know, it's like, whoa. Okay. And all of this is happening on the inside of us.
That's right. All the time. And that's where it, going back to the statement you had made earlier too, we're governing ourselves. Speaking of that, in the meridians, we have the governing, which is in the back end, and then we have the conception. These meridians are active 24 hours of the day.
Right.
As opposed to the other 12, which have that 2-hour cycle that they're highest and most active. but the governing and the conception are 24 hours a day, the receiving stimuli.
Wow. Okay, so now, I know you said that your daughter and you birthing her, you having the honor of birthing her, was your intro into the desire to want to get into the healing industry, the healing field, to be, to be really a birther of health, a birther of mobility, motion, frequency, all of those things, energy mover, an energy shifter. Yes, that's what you, energy shifter. So, but what is your own journey with your own, because I know you're a former athlete, okay? And you went from being an athlete to being an international athletic trainer, okay? And so talk about your journey, your transition. Talk about what it was that caused you to transition from being an athlete to being the athletic trainer, and then your own journey in your own healing that you had to, with healing yourself.
That's a great question. And thank you for that, Queen. Oh, man, that's so awesome. Because that really sent the projection on my life.
Okay.
I was always training athletes and training myself to be the best shape that I could be. And when you want the best for yourself, you become focused on what things can actually make that happen.
Right.
So what it was I had torn my everything in my ankle and tore all my ligaments in there. And that started to cause knee problems, right? Because those connect. So I had to learn about the IT band, your iliotal band, which runs through the outside. It's the longest fascia that we have in our entire body. And that runs from basically like your hip all the way down to your ankle. And so that was damaged. Then I had to learn how to breathe to it. And then I started seeing the results. I tore my groin muscle playing volleyball. I tore my my PCL in the back of my knee, playing sports. And so it was all about, I didn't need any surgery for any of that. Right? Where people get surgery for that stuff all the time.
All the time.
But what I was doing was breathing and stretches. So working with the athletes, working with Libyan national basketball team, I was over in Africa. I was over in Turkey and Istanbul, went to Germany, came back, and all these guys were just getting such magnificent results and learning about nutrition and stuff as well. From early on with Dr. Sebi, of learning about the electrical foods and how the diet matters as far as how the body regenerates the tissue, as well as age. Also, we always factor in the younger you are, the faster you regenerate the tissue. But the whole factor was is that we regenerate the tissue. It doesn't just stop. It doesn't, we don't break a leg or break a ankle and it just, never go back to being the same. What happened, what we learned is that actually when you do surgery and you put something in the body that's not natural, that's when it's going to not ever be the same thing. But we can regenerate the tissue. We can heal the bones. And so, that was my focus. It was like, man, there's so many athletes, they get hurt all the time, and let's work with it. So I remember working with the Tampa Bay Buccaneer, a couple of their D linemen, and they came to me, they tore their groin. One was out an entire season. Now, if you can imagine, that's a whole entire paycheck that could have been, a lot more for the family. So he came to me, Courtney Brown, shout him out to him. He came to me and he was like, man, I missed all last year. Someone told me about you and it was another Tampa Bay Bucks player. And so I was working with him and next thing, I'll never forget, we finished the first session and after he had came about the groin problem, we did it in the gym and he got up and he said, "Man, Joe, what did you do?
Right.
Oh, I don't even feel it no more." He was like, "That's magic." And, you know, and so it took off from there. But,
yeah,
you know, really focusing on it. But again, it all came about the mobility of the body. And so when I was working with 90-year-old people or, you know, 70-year-old people,
right,
however age they are, you see that no, there's our body, the way it's made, is always supposed to go and do certain motions.
True.
If it can't, there's a blockage.
Yeah.
So what do you have to do to it? It's just like laying in the bed and you're like, "Oh, I'm laying on this side. There's something cramping." Mm-hmm. And then you're like, "Oh, let me turn to the other side." Mm-hmm. Instead mm-hmm. of actually examining, what I'm doing is examining, why is that? Why yeah. is there a cramp there? Yeah. Now let's breathe to it. And yeah. so that's where it took off. Mm-hmm. And, you know, just getting results. It took Darlene, she was an amazing patient of mine. Mm-hmm. She had a motor neuron. She had a stiff person syndrome, ataxia, which is a motor neuron disease, and MS. She was plus 50 years old, and she had never done anything outside of using the pharmaceuticals and right. all that. And she really wasn't getting any progress.
Mm-hmm.
So her niece got in contact with me, and I started working with her. In 10 sessions, 10 sessions, 1 hour and 15 minutes each week. So 10 sessions, one session a week. She went from a wheelchair and cane to jogging on the treadmill. And I had footage of that, and it was just like,
wow. 10 sessions, no surgery.
No,
and eventually, I'm assuming off of the pharmaceuticals.
That's right. And one of the first pictures she showed me was mm-hmm. of her dishes being washed. That she had, and she had said, "I wash my dishes," and she had the ability for yeah. over 20 plus years.
Yeah,
you know,
10 sessions, one session a week.
That's right.
And
breathe into wow. every part of the body, clearing out the blockages in the electrical right. system.
Yeah. My goodness. Listen, you all, if you're hearing this and you know that these are areas that you know you need assistance in, then you really, really need to listen in. But you also, and we're going to, before the session it's over, we're going to talk about how they can reach you, how they can, you know, he's located in LA, but that doesn't mean that he's not willing to be wherever you need him to be. Whether it's a virtual session, whether it's he got to fly in where you are, you know what I'm saying? All of those things. This is necessary. Okay, we need to understand, and I talked about this last week when I went live. I said, we from birth were equipped with every single tool that we need and we will ever need in this life's journey. Problem is, we are fully armed, fully tooled, with no manual in sight. We don't know how to use none of the stuff we got on our hip. We got wonderful, magnificent utility belts. Okay. But don't know how to use none of it. Okay. So here's the thing. These are avenues in which you can learn more about you, the power of you, the tools that are in your belt so that you can use them to heal yourself. That is the thing you need to tap in, you all. Really, really, really tap in, communicate all of those things. Again, stay tuned because we will talk about, he will let you know how you can reach him and all of those things, how you can communicate. You know, even if it's not you, you have parents, you have grandparents, you have neighbors, you have coworkers, you have children, you got people that requires this level of attention, okay? You do, all right? So we need to stay tuned, okay? Now, Amazing. All of this is amazing, but I want to get into the more creative side of you, the artistic side of you, okay? And that is the author, the poet, okay? Yes, he's a poet and you know it, okay? Ooh. So when it comes out, when it, you are a published author.
Correct.
Congratulations on your published material.
Thank you. I do have another one coming out soon. Yes. It's going to be called Homeostatic Resonance. I was first published back in, 2007 was the first time I was published.
Okay.
And Immaculate Verses. And then the Best Poets of 2008 and 2009.
Okay.
And then, and then I did it with the, I was like, man, I need to really put out something to lay my mark, you know? Yeah. And so I put out The Color of My Sky is Black.
Yes. And The Color of My Sky is Black. First of all, that's poetry in and of itself. The Color of My Sky is Black. Explain that. Explain the title. Explain the motivation behind The Color of My Sky is Black.
This is a tribute to our ancestors and my ancestors and to everyone that ever felt marginalized in any type of way. And it's to literally bring insight to Black being the most powerful color there is, because it's the encompassing of all the colors.
Yes, it is.
And so that's why it was like, you know, there's so many negative connotations when we use the word black with certain things, you know, they think of like Black Death and so on and so forth. So me coming to age and always building off of what my ancestors have done and my predecessors, I was like, let me flip the script on it, you know, let's show how beautiful and amazing the color black is, you know, and why is that? So that's where it was like, The Color of My Sky is Black, because the first poem on it is Look Up, right? Mm-hmm. And it says, the whole of earth, water, the entire of sun, fire, what holds them and everything in it? Facts, the color of my sky is black. So, you know, because if you literally keep looking up,
yeah.
Blackness encompasses all of it.
That's right. That's awesome. That is awesome. I do get the privilege of listening to, I get personally hand delivered some material. So when I get it, I listen to it, and man, you just released an album.
The Love Over Hate. Mm-hmm.
The Love Over Hate album. When I tell you there's one, first of all of them are amazing. Where can they find Love Over Hate?
Oh man, you know, I know it's on Google Music still, and Amazon Music as well is where they'll be able to find Love Over Hate album.
Love Over Hate.
Mantra Music.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Mantra Music. There is one that is called, or it says, I'm willing to change.
Yes.
Oh my goodness. Listen, first of all, we know that change is necessary, constant change, because who I am right now at this moment is a more evolved version of who I was when we started this segment, okay? The reason I say that is because I'm sitting here, I'm absorbing the wisdom that Uriel is giving us. However, so that means that even now, I'm a better version of who I was before we started this interview. You know what I'm saying? So as we, each moment, each second, each hour that passes, we're constantly evolving. So change is happening whether we realize it or not. You can be changed, you can evolve or change or be influenced by Again, music, sound, whatever the case, either way, whether you're changing for the better or the worse, that you are different now than you was 10 minutes ago. Okay. So it's always changing, just like the universe. Universe is always moving, always shifting, always, you know what I'm saying? Now, with that being said, the willingness to change is a total different thing.
That's the whole key. You know, and when we resist that, that's when we stay in rigid patterns.
Yes.
Learning that lesson of howing to give up those ideologies that we've held on to so long. That's the only thing. All that does is help to build on top of our character as well as our etheric being. Because if you think about it, our skin, right, is a perfect example of that healing, regeneration, and changing. Yeah. Every single day, little skin particles come off that
dirt, right?
And then it comes right back over. Yeah. But if our body was rigid and saying, no, I want to stay the same, that's going to start a blockage. And we do that mentally as well. Yes. So it's important to, that's why another major reason I devised the harmonic vibrational, because the understanding of the harmonic vibrational is all about re-changing that mind frame. We were always taught A, E, I, O, U is the vowel scale.
Right.
That's based off of how the alphabet is.
Mm-hmm.
But octavely, that is totally incorrect.
That's right.
Totally incorrect. So that's why I devised the harmonic vibrational. U-O-A-E-I. You know, to give that to the children so they can know, oh man, all I have to do is vibrationally retrain my mind to scale up correctly.
That's right. Because we are frequency, nature is frequency, cosmos is frequency, the planets have frequency, colors have frequencies. Everything is frequency. Everything is frequency, everything is energy. And it's moving, it's passing, it's always vibrating. That's why even in our words, when we speak them, we're emitting vibrations and frequency, because words are vibrations. Even when we say things, it comes with sound. That is a frequency. That is a vibration. If you were to place your, like with if you were just to say whatever, in the next sentence that you say, place your fingers right at your throat and your fingers will be vibrating. Okay.
Right.
But the only thing that you hear is sound. You don't feel the vibration. You don't hear the vibration. You hear frequency, but you feel the vibration when you place your, it's always frequency based, energy based, vibration based.
That's right. That's right. And so that's why devising these, and this is something you guys definitely, I really put a lot of work into these charts, because the charts give you on both sides. They give you the metaphysical understanding as well as the frequency power, the colors, and so on and so forth.
Yeah.
What it's going to do is give you a literal pathway of how to heal yourself vibrationally.
Yes. And even when you do that, my mom and I were talking last night, and she was like, I am now understanding why you say that although you love everybody, there's only a certain amount of or level of people or conversations that you're going to in engage in. There's only a certain crowd of people that you're going to put yourself in. The reason is because you recognize the power of energy, vibrations, frequency, all of that, those things. And when you have evolved to a certain level, and not to say that you're better than anybody, because no, we're all walking each other, holding each other hand, walking each other home. We are all the same, just living different versions of different lives. We're all one. However, when you have come from a place right? If you've healed in areas and you've come from a place, then why would you remain in that place? You have got to keep moving. You got to keep transitioning. You got to keep changing. You also have to become more protective of your new sacred evolved self, because you know what it took to get you from that place to this new place. So it's insanity to go back there, because then you're going to have to do all of that work all over again. And you know, it didn't feel good to unhinge from some of these things in the first place. You know that it was a transformation, a metamorphosis. You had to unbecome something to become something. You had to unlearn to relearn. And so it was very uncomfortable. Change is always uncomfortable, but it's necessary. So when you evolve to a place, then you no longer are going to be putting yourself intentionally on purpose in areas that are that'll cause you to be sick all over again. Okay. Right. Like for real, that's when you know, when you guard, yes, gotta protect your peace, guard your gates. Yes, yes, yes. When you come from a place, it's like, okay, I couldn't move before. Mm-hmm. Now I can. So I dare not put myself back in a place where I'm immobile. I cannot put myself back in a place where I can no longer, I can't wash dishes again, because I know what that feels like. And I choose to be on the hillside versus the sick side. I choose to stay here. So that means, you know what I'm saying? That willingness, I'm willing to change. I'm willing to undo some things. I'm willing to detach from some people. I'm willing to change.
Yes. You've got to be willing. Apologize as well. You know,
man,
the power in apologizing to yourself and saying, yes, I wasn't thinking right when I did that. You know, You're giving yourself that grace. Yeah. This is the acceptance and that which allows you to move forward.
Right.
But if you stay stuck in that rigid energy, you're not going to want to change, let alone be willing to change.
Exactly. Exactly. That willingness is necessary. You got to be willing to do it in order for it to, because it's consensual.
That's right.
You understand what I'm saying? Because spirit is not going to do anything for you or with you or to you unless you first give access and permission for change. Change is here, but are you willing to allow change to do its job for you? You gotta be willing. You gotta be willing. And so that willingness matters, man. That willingness matters. Now, I do have, yes, yes, as she says, growth. Yes. I do have a clip from one of your poems that I enjoy, because it's like, whoa, right? But I'm also going to impress upon you two right here, impromptu. I know I didn't ready you for this. to give us, you know, a little feel, a little spit, you know, after I finish, after this plays here. This is a short, you know, 1 minute, 12 second clip, but it's listen, simple yet impactful, right? Okay, so here we go, y'all.
I won't. I'm a winner.
Peace. I'm inspired. That's what I call love. I'm inspired. That's what I call love. It's a catalyst. The best is love. When you retrain your mind, you can understand what is love, what is not. And making that distinction alone can lead you to the right path. Of happiness, of peace, of care, and understanding. Peace.
Fresh and free. Now that the dirt has.
I'm inspired. That's what I call love. Listen to me. Everybody just calm down. Everybody just relax, okay? Everybody just chill out, because I know, because I'm about to run around my desk right now. I'm inspired. That's what I call love. I'm inspired. I'm inspired to create. I'm inspired to learn. I'm inspired to grow. I'm inspired to heal. I'm inspired to help. I'm inspired to share. Those are the things. Inspiration is what I call love. Because if you're inspired to do something, then there's a love there. There's a love connection there to do, to be inspired to do it in the first place. When you said, that's how you know the distinction between what is love and what is not. Is there an inspiration there?
Ooh.
Right. Is there inspiration? Because if there is not no inspiration, is that really love?
Ooh.
Boy, listen, I saw that and almost fell out the chair. Okay. Listen, here's my mom. She says, I am willing to change.
Oh, yes.
I'm willing to change. Boy, that thing did something to me. Inspiration. I'm inspired. That's what I call love. If inspiration is not present, can you even call it love?
You know, and as a child, we learned this very early, right?
Yeah. Yep.
It's what we attach to. We attach to the certain things in our environment, like our parents, if we have parents, or our brothers and sisters. And so we can simply say, you know, I have an attachment. I'm inspired to talk to them. I'm inspired to know more about them. I'm inspired to be around them, to even be in their frequency or resonance. That alone is a product of love. And that's why I say it's a catalyst, because it's just like looking at something that you've never seen before, but you look at it and it's like, wow, what is that? Yeah, you're inspired.
Yep. Those endorphins, you're releasing those fluids, like, ooh. And then in that inspiration resides love.
Yeah.
You know, love for self, because you're inspired. So that love for self is like, ooh, I give myself the permission to do whatever I'm inspired to do. Love for the art, love for the thing that inspired you, love for the person that inspired you, love for the environment, because it can be a scenery that inspires you. And in that scenery, there's love, love and appreciation and gratitude, all of those things. Listen, love transcends that butterfly feeling that we've been so, that tangible, you know, sensational, you know, love at first sight type of situation. That all of those things are human constructs, okay? Love transcends all of that. Love is also correction. So if it comes down to being inspired to change, being inspired to undo, being inspired to turn my ways, being inspired, therein lies love.
Yes, perfect example. I met you, I heard mm-hmm. your voice, mm-hmm. it inspired me. Yeah. I love you because I'm inspired literally just listening to you. Mm-hmm. That's a perfect example of love.
Yeah.
You know? And when it's true, it's not something you can just leave at the wayside.
True.
You know? And that's not how it works. And that's what sometimes spurts on addictions as well. You know? So, yeah.
Now, you said something right there. Now, that's going into my arena of healing, which is cognitive behavioral therapy. Like the reasons, what triggered this addiction? What caused this behavior? Okay. Now, the behavior is the byproduct of.
That's right.
I'm not worried about the action. I'm not worried about the behavior. I need to get to the seed, the inspiration of where it came from, why it happened. Why it was allowed, what brought it on, what made you give the permission for this thing, this act, Ooh. This whatever.
Yes.
That's the thing. And therein lies your healing, because you pluck that seed, you eradicate and prevent the action.
Ooh, that's so powerfully said. And that is, like you said, that's the key. That's grabbing at the root.
Right.
And then you look at another principle of the of healing sound, the right. accumulative and detectable effects.
Right.
So now, when you have some of these compulsions or these behaviors, and you mm-hmm. look at the cumulative effects, mm-hmm. of it, now you're coming to back to the now, because right. you are cumulative of all the experiences.
Yeah.
Not just one or two. And then you have to look at, well, what have I been eating the most? Who have I been loving the most? Who have I been focused on? And so on and so forth. That is just a whole rabbit hole, that accumulative detectable effects.
And it takes an inner scope. It takes what in tarot we call the hermit moment. It takes that isolation, that introspective work, reflection. It takes all of that. And it takes transparency and honesty. Because one thing about it,
yes.
you are with you 24/7. You can lie to me all day, okay? Although spirit will reveal the lie, trust. I am a walking, talking human lie detector. Believe that, okay? Yeah. However, you can't lie to self.
That's right. Because that's all you end up lying to, is yourself. You lie to yourself.
That's it. So it takes that introspective work. It takes bravery to even tell self the truth. It takes bravery to even step into to become willing to change. It takes that bravery. And a lot of people are not willing to face those hard things because, oh, it's so uncomfortable. I don't want to go back to that childhood trauma. I don't want to go back to that hurt, that heartbreak. I don't want to go back to that abuse. I don't want to face it. I just want to be, you know, forget about it, out of sight, out of mind. But you don't understand that those things that you say are out of sight, out of mind, they are very much so in your mind. They are very much so embedded in your spirit, and very much so embedded in your psyche, which is transcending, is transitioning over into your physical self, your blockages, your muscles being stiff, your bones being stiff, all of the diseases, dis-ease, abuse, abnormal use, all of those things. It all, one thing causes another thing to occur.
That's right. It's
all connected.
It's all connected.
Man.
Especially when we're dealing with, you know, like, this is a great example, mm-hmm. sexually, right?
Yeah.
You'll have men as they get older mm-hmm. where they won't be able to have an erection.
Right.
We know for a fact,
mm-hmm.
because of where that is in your chakra energy,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That is a blockage down there in that sacral area.
Yeah, it's down there
in that coccyx area. Yep. And so that's our base and our foundation, our leg, our groin, our feet. That's just the foundational area, that sexual area chakra.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The O, the red, the orange. And so what happens is that also is connected to our heart.
It is.
And that's where you get the medication, what's it called, that men sometimes take.
Is it the Cialis? Is it the Viagra? Yeah. That type of stuff?
Mm-hmm. That was actually started out, if you do the research on that, that was started out as a heart medication.
Yes, exactly.
To help your blood pump. And so when you look at that and you reciprocate that, bam, there it goes.
Right.
Some people are having very congested hearts. And so then they can't perform sexually.
Yeah.
Especially when you've gone through the trauma and not faced it. You just kept it all in. You've never really.
See? And even in the sacral, because, you know, those my jams. I'm a chakra mama, okay? So when it comes down to that area, too, that area affects your creativity.
That's right.
Your ability to express. it affects, you know, like that fun area of you. You know what I'm saying? It affects those things. And so, yes, being connected to your heart, then of course, if there's a blockage, and understand this, here's another one, and I'm gonna say this and I'm gonna move on. If you're blocked in the sacral, which is the 3D chakra, then and it's supposed to be a flow from through all of them. Then if you're blocked at the second chakra, then what makes you think there's a flow to the solar plexus or the heart or the throat or the third eye or the crown? You're blocked in all of those because there's no flow being given, being sent to there. You understand what I'm saying? That's something is blocking the air passages. And if you're stuck right there, then you're stuck in every other place after that too.
That's right. And how does that display itself? With anger.
Anger. That's speaking up for yourself. Having fuzzy thoughts and a forgetfulness and you know, lacking discernment. All it plays out in it. Not feeling empowered, not feeling, you know, not feeling a sense of self or, you know, who I am and all of that. Now, listen, it's a whole lot of stuff
from that, right?
Listen, I'm telling you. Listen, this is why this conversation was necessary, because it's not just a you know, just go and do a sit-up and call it a day. Oh, no. We have some of the buffest people that are still struggling internally, spiritually, mentally, emotionally, sexually, because they don't understand that it's all connected.
All connected. And, okay. And we see it play out time and time again. Yep. And just for that's talking metaphysically, when we look at it from the physical standpoint, we know that when you're balancing yourself, you're contracting those core muscles. So, those people that tend to be blocked down there tend to be off balance.
True.
So, you know, that's why when I do workouts and stuff, I don't just do curls, right?
Yeah.
I curl on one foot, standing on one foot, and my core is contracting, and now I fall. You know, so you're because what you want to do is maximize the muscle contractions.
Sure.
That's how you get the best results out of it. Maximizing muscle contractions instead of just isolating muscles. And you want to work out. This is the best advice I definitely give to people on a whole scale. Is you want to work out all of the muscles in your sessions. You don't want to just pick in
leg day.
Arm day, all that stuff. That's 1970s and 80s. That was what they were doing. But we know about the body now and how it works. It goes back to, like we were talking about, and like you just stated, you want to have that whole
circulating.
That's
right. Oh. Nice. Very good. Okay. So lastly, and this is majorly important for you, because you beam. Oh my goodness. I absolutely love hearing you speak of this title that you hold so honorably, right? And that is the title of Father.
Yes.
Okay, that is the title of Father. You were able to, you birthed her, you brought her into this world. This is your daughter, your princess, Isis. Talk to us about Isis and being a father to a daughter, being a father to, you know, in the healing arena to a daughter, in this time, in these times where we have these Gen Zs, okay, how is it being a father to a 16-year-old daughter from your perspective, and how has fatherhood altered and changed you as the man?
It's changed me in every way. It really, I was always pretty patient, but being a father makes you be patient in a whole nother level. Especially in early on, I had to take care of her, you know, and nurture her myself. Mm-hmm. So what it kept me in the mind frame was, how was my life? It gave me that retrospection of how was my life and how can I help guide her to a better life? Mm-hmm. Because I remember thinking, you know, I can do it. Oh, yeah. I'm this, I'm that.
Right.
But you, until you realize I need help. And so when you have a baby, it gives you that understanding of they need help. They need to be fed. They need to, you know, their diaper changed. Oh, right. It's time for them to go to bed. And it helped me restructure my life around what's most important as opposed to what I want. Because when you have a child, that's what one thing it really it steers you on is, well, I have to learn sacrifice. And so I always want to teach her those lessons as I go along because I learn from her. So there are so many ways I could go with this. Isis starts throwing her in the pool and putting a floaty on her at 12 months, you know, so that she learned to swim. She doesn't even remember learning to swim now. But I'll ask her about it. She just knows she's been swimming all her life. She knows, she knows she wanted to surf. And so that took me down to learning to surf, you know. I'll never forget. This is one of the most compassionate things. Look at it. Beautiful. Oh, Marketel right there. it's a beautiful bird. So Isis was, you know, I stopped and I was getting gas, right? Mm-hmm. And she used to always want to get out the car when I'm pumping gas. Right. So I got her out. She was about 2.5. And I'm pumping the gas and she's sitting there and then I finished and I put it back and I look at her and she's down on the ground and she has a spider just walking on her. And I'm like, that's interesting. No fear, no problems or anything, you know? It was just, this is a living organism and I'm harmonizing with it. Mm-hmm. I'm getting to know it. So I bought her a rabbit and she named it Coco and she loved playing with this. We found out it was blind. So she was teaching me the whole time about having compassion for life and seeing things on a broad perspective. Mm-hmm. She's also the one that got me back into listening to Michael Jackson because I was like, why does she like Michael Jackson so much? Like she was always MJ, she wanted to dance with. And then we got the game, the Michael Jackson Experience, and she was going to dance with. At that time, you know, there was a lot of propaganda in the US and stuff. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you think little things and some comedians would joke stuff. And that made me dive deeper into and learn that, you know, all the falsehoods and, you know, all that stuff was just a whole bunch of bad mess. But because her pure heart, she knew that, you know, that person was an angel and wanted to listen to it. So she's taught so many lessons. I love you, Isis. If you can listen to her, you know, Bubble, I'll talk to you soon. She's taught me so many lessons, though. Mm-hmm. And what it did was it made me understand more about harmonizing with my environment and with all human mankind.
That's so awesome. Oh, that's so dope. I love that. Okay, so final question. Before we release you today, thank you so very much for this. This has been an amazing dynamic conversation. I'm telling you, necessary conversation. Okay, so this, I'm not sure if you've been asked this before. I hope you have not. But tell the people something that they may not or no one may know about Uriel Riley. What is one thing that, you know, like a habit of yours or a favorite whatever of yours that no one knows and you've never shared publicly to anybody? What is that one thing?
That's a great question. I've never been asked that before.
Yeah.
Let's see. because I'm very transparent.
Okay.
I would say something that no one really knows about me is that is that Wow, that is deep. Oh my God. Oh my gosh. Okay. Here's a great one that I didn't, because of a childhood trauma, because I was molested by a friend and of the hall of my parents.
Gotcha. Okay.
I didn't like to draw. Now I've embraced it and I draw all the time. That's why.
Oh my goodness. Exactly. Like, even when, okay, so I'm going to say this too. Even when Uriel sends me things or whatever, every single section is in a written in a different color. Every single thing, and you draw, you know, all of those things in different colors. So I would never have known that whatsoever. So gratitude to you for healing. Okay. It's horrible because I went through, you know, something similar, however, in different perspectives with different, you know what I'm saying? Pretty much the same result, trauma. Okay. However, the healing that came from it, because what if you were still kind of bound by that? Then your ability to express in color would not have been. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
And
I correlated with, it was the time when I was learning how to draw.
Yeah.
That's when it happened, when I was 5 or 6 and I was learning those skills set. That's when I was molested. And and so that's, I grew up thinking, I'll never draw. I can't draw. I would even write it in some of my poems until I accepted it, till I spoke it out, until I told my parents and, you know, notified other people that were close to me, like, this happened to me and this is the effect it had. That could have had such a horrible, more effect if I would have just kept it in. But releasing that trauma, facing it, that's what we learned. Facing it, you know, just like you were talking the other night about the gamification in Mario Brothers, right?
When
that ghost is going to keep following you until you turn around in Mario Brothers and look at it. So that was something I had to face and really say, no, that happened to me. And say, this person, the Lamont, he touched me when I was little. And, you know, so when I was able to verbalize that, it literally released my creativity.
Yeah, that is amazing. That is amazing. And I know we're not gonna dive into it here because that's a whole nother segment.
I know.
getting through those traumas from a male perspective.
That's right.
Because it happens more often than we actually hear about it. Because there's this pride in men that they don't want to share that because they don't want to appear weak or homosexual, or you know what I'm saying? It's all these stigmas, again, human societal constructs, you know, that keeps them bound and stuck to that trauma. It keeps them from being able to move forward, even, or to move forward from the past into embracing the moment, these moments, present day moments, and going to the future, because they're steadily bringing past to present. Because they're steadily carrying past. So it's not even past. It might have happened when you were 5, but if you keep holding on to it, it's still happening when you're 55.
It's going to continue to happen at 65
because you're going to let go.
That's right. If you're still sitting in that soil, you know, you're supposed to change the soil to your plants, right? After we get to a certain level.
Right.
And so when you're just sitting in it, that's because you haven't found the tools, if you will, to get through that problem.
Right. Wow, wow, wow. That's a whole other segment. And I am willing to have that one too, because it's necessary. That's when you're going off into the mental and the emotional and all of those things, the blockages and stuff like that, and why, you know, you can't open yourself up to love or to affection or to embracing or to all of those things because of things that have happened in your past, and that, you know, and it's caused you to put yourself into a cement cell. You know what I'm saying? Where you are the cell, where you are the inmate, but you're also the warden with the key. Okay. So,
It starts, you start projecting that on your whole world, thinking everyone is like that.
That's a fact. That's a fact. And you start to operate out of defensiveness because you have to be on guard all the time. Yeah. Because that one time that you had your defenses down, you were affected, you were attacked, you were mistreated, you were all of those things. So now I have to have my guard up all the time because you're not going to get me again. You know what I mean? So my mom says acknowledgement, being open and honest, leads to the process of the willing, being willing to change.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
The acknowledgement. And, you know, we learn that, as you know, that, as a doctor yourself, you know, that's the first part of therapy.
It is.
Accepting and acknowledging it. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. This was phenomenal.
No. Dr. thank you so much. Highest heart love. You are such an amazing, amazing person. Gratitude. Highest love.
That's awesome. Now tell the people, thank you so very much. Gratitude to you for accepting the invite. I had to get you on here. I think we've been in association for how long? Probably maybe two years now.
Yeah, at least. Yeah, a little bit more maybe now.
A little bit over 2 years. Yeah. So listen, y'all. Okay, you know, because I care about you all and I love this platform and I love the people that I reach. We're worldwide over here, okay? And we've been worldwide for a very long time. And I do not put just any old body in front of you. You understand? Okay? If you're looking at them on my platform, trust and believe they've been vetted by me a billion, billion, billion times over, okay? Trust and believe it, okay? So this is one that this is a contact, a person, a spirit, a soul, and a man, an entity that you absolutely must have in your contacts. Okay. You have to. Please let them know how they can reach you.
Oh, that's wonderful. Yes. You can send me an email, especially if you guys want any of the charts that I make, because these charts again are for the people. You can send me an email at urielriley.gmail.com. Okay. urielriley@gmail.com. That's if you like to get any of the charts, and then as well as you can find me on Instagram.
Okay.
You can find me at Instagram at RealRealUriel, or you can go to my Your Healing page, okay, on Instagram, and then on YouTube you can find me at Uriel Riley and the Real Rail as well.
The real rail.
Yeah, that's what my friends called me. So when I started these accounts, I started them, you know, based off, hey, this is what my friends, you know, this is the way I contact. So
okay.
And Facebook as well, you could just find my name.
Gotcha. Okay. Sounds good. And the name is Uriel Riley. Listen, of course, commonly pronounced as Uriel. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes, Uriel. And of course, everybody says Uriel. Yes, it's him. Okay. So you all listen, be sure to again, his email address, email him at urielriley@gmail.com. It's on the screen, urielriley@gmail.com. Or you can find it, just type in Uriel Riley on any platform, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and you will find him there. Okay. Thank you so very much. Is there any last words you want to share to the people before we go?
I just want to say highest heart love to every single one of you. And remember that you are your greatest healer. Yeah. You have the ability. It's all in your breath. Remember, your breath is life.
Ooh, your breath is life. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Thank you so very much, Uriel. One more time, I appreciate you. Yes. You all listen, you already know it's I love you. There's nothing else for me to add there, okay? I love you. I mean it. There's absolutely positively nothing, and I mean nothing that you can do about it. Don't you even try it. We will see you all on Sunday. We're starting our book written by Brianna Weiss. It's called The Mountain Is You. The mountain is you. You definitely want to be there. If you don't have the book and you would like to acquire your PDF copy, downloadable copy, inbox me or email me, and you can get a copy for $5. That's it. That's all guaranteed. You will not buy that book anywhere else for $5. Okay. Just saying. Okay. So I'm just giving it to you because, you know, my time and my labor. Okay. Don't waste my time. All right. So with that being said, we will see you all on Sunday, but I love you all. I mean it. There's absolutely positively nothing you can do about it. Don't you even try it. We will see you all on Sunday. Thank you again, Uriel.
See you soon. Gratitude. Peace.
Peace.